Welcome to Beware the Scare. My name is Tyler Style, and today we're going to be looking at Saw 7, or Saw 3D if you want to go with the original title. Like Saw 6, this movie was directed by Kevin Grootert, and it's probably the weakest in the entire franchise. But that doesn't necessarily mean the movie's bad, but who cares? We came for the gruesome traps, and in Saw 7 we get a lot of those. If you enjoy any part of this video, please consider liking it and maybe even leaving me a nice comment. They literally make my day. If you like horror content, you should consider subscribing. It's free, you know. But enough of that. I'll stop blabbing and let's get to the movie. We start the movie where the first Saw movie left off, with Lawrence Gordon crawling out of the bathroom. He goes to a hot pole and uses it to make sure he doesn't bleed out, leading us to the present day. We go to the very first Saw trap in public. Brad and Ryan are in the trap as people watch. Hanging above them is Dina, their girlfriend. Yeah, I said there. Dina is cheating on both of them with each other, and one of the three has to die. Real quick, how the fuck did Hoffman manage to build this trap and put them inside of it with no one seeing? The people try to break the glass, but there's no luck. Billy joins the club and tells Brad and Ryan that they can either play the opposite of tug of war, maybe push of war, or they can sacrifice the cheating bitch Dina and save themselves. The game starts and the boys go at it. And after Brad starts taking the lead, Dina starts rooting for him. But then, when Ryan takes the lead, Dina starts rooting for him. They decide that she's not worth it, and Ryan gives us the worst line in Saw history.
I think we're breaking up with you, Dina.
Dina gets cut in half, and we go to the title card. We start off where we left off in Saw 6, and Jill is running down the hall. She hides and watches Hoffman walk past her. He stitches himself up and we go back to Jill, who is in an interrogation room with Detective Gibson. She tells him that Hoffman is Jigsaw's accomplice and she asks to be put in a protection program. We go back to Hoffman, who destroys his phone, and I guess that's why they call it a burner phone. He collects the images of the new contestants for this movie's game, and we go to an interview with Bobby, a Jigsaw survivor who wrote a book on his story. He talks about how he had to insert hooks into his pectoral muscles and hoist himself up to survive. When the interview wraps up, his publicist Nina is upset that he didn't have a big kiss with his wife Joyce at the end of the interview. Jill is walking out of the police department and sees cop cars and a tricycle. She gets got by Mr. Piggy and it looks like she's in an unwinnable trap. I thought the point of these games were to give people the chance to live, but she gets split in half, and it turns out it was only just a dream. We go to a new game and it stars Evan, Dan, Kara, and Jake. Kara is played by Gabby West, who just like Tandra Howard did in Saw 6, won her spot by winning the second season of the VH1 TV show Scream Queens. Evan is super glued to the back of a car seat and has 30 seconds to rip his skin off to get a lever by the hood of the car. The reason why they're in this trap is because they're racists. Evan starts ripping through the seat and really makes a valiant effort, but it's not enough. The timer runs out and the car drops on Kara. The car drives forward and makes Dan's limbs get ripped off and Jake gets hit with the car. Finally, the car crashes and Evan flies out of the window, ending his life. We go to a Jigsaw survivors meeting and we see some notable faces, like Simone from Saw 6, who still doesn't think the game changed her.
You wanna know the best thing that happened to me? After having to cut off my own arm, is handicapped parking at the damn mall!
We also see Addie from Saw 6, Malik from Saw 5, and Dr. Lawrence Gordon sitting in the back like a creepy mofo.
I'm sure I speak for everyone here when I say how grateful we are to be part of your promotional DVD.
Bobby walks to his car and gets kidnapped by the pigster himself. Gibson gets a call from Rogers and he's at the last game. They zip up the bodies and Gibson finds his name on a mirror and the reverse bear trap. Bobby wakes up in a metal cage and Billy comes on the TV and tells Bobby that he is going to be tested because he's been lying about being in a trap this entire time. If Bobby doesn't complete the game within 60 minutes, then his wife Joyce will die. Billy gets off the screen and the cage Bobby's in gets hoisted. It's hanging over some metal spikes and he pulls a handle that removes the floor to the cage. He almost falls but catches himself. I always wondered, what happens if he just died right there? Does that mean everyone would just sit there until they die? He swings his way out of the cage and we go to a flashback where he got the idea to fake his survival story. Gibson talks to Jill at the safe house and they figure out that Jill tried to kill Hoffman with the reverse bear trap. He calls her crazy, like, a lot.
You're crazy. You know that? I knew you were crazy the minute I laid eyes on you, crazy.
Then, he tells her she's going to stay there because it's a safe house and Hoffman wouldn't know she's there. Until a few seconds later when they get a DVD sent to them starring Hoffman himself. Before he plays the DVD, he gets a call from Rogers about a small explosion at the car lot. A bigger explosion happens during the call and he hangs up and plays the DVD. Hoffman offers a proposal. He will stop the game as long as they give him Jill. Bobby is walking down the hall and goes to his first real test with Nina. She has to stay quiet while he pulls a fish hook and key out of her stomach. If she doesn't stay quiet, then some metal rods will pierce through her neck. She can't stay silent and ends up getting killed.
Why would you just shut the fuck up?
Bobby goes to the next room and sees one of his signed books. He remembers when he signed the book for John Kramer, and I'm sorry John, but that backwards hat style doesn't work for anyone over like 20. Tobin Bell, the man who plays John, actually got paid the most money out of everyone in this movie, even though he only had 3 minutes of screen time. Gibson is watching the Hoffman tape and sees a little statue behind Hoffman and recognizes it, but can't really remember where it's from. Bobby goes to his next desk and it's with his lawyer, Suzanne. Billy comes flying through the window and says that he needs to lift a bar and get stabbed for a certain amount of time within 60 seconds. If he can't take the pain for that long, then Suzanne's eyes and mouth will be pierced. He can't hold on for that long, and Suzanne dies. Hoffman sends the detectives an email with a cryptic video.
Look beyond the crossroad to the clear dawn. Do you see it?
I don't understand what the fuck that means, but Gibson does, and they run out of the room. Bobby gets to his next test, and he has to help his best friend, Kale, walk over some planks, but Kale's blindfolded. If the noose isn't off of his neck within 60 seconds, then Kale's gonna get fucked up. Bobby starts helping Kale and is doing a great job until Kale steps on a plank that can't hold his weight. He catches himself on another plank, and Bobby gets the key from the middle of the room. With time running out, Bobby has to throw the key to Kale, but Kale drops it. Meaning, he's fucked. He gets hung and he's flying around like Peter Pan the musical. Gibson and Rogers are at the location of Hoffman's video and Gibson tells the story of how Hoffman saved his life. A homeless man attacked Gibson and Hoffman told him to put his hands up. The homeless man does and Hoffman shoots him for no apparent reason. Gibson figures out where the game is being played and tells Rogers to stay with Jill. We go back to Bobby and Billy tells him that he needs to pull out two of his molars to get the correct code to open the door to get to Joyce. The SWAT team enters the building with 17 minutes left and Bobby starts ripping out his teeth. After a lot of blood, he finally gets one of them out and Gibson gets a call from Palmer, who got the location of where Hoffman's email was sent from. It was sent from the car lot from Evan's game. After even more blood, Bobby gets the combination and opens the door. Gibson goes to the car lot and finds a hidden door where his name was written. Him and a couple officers walk into a room where they see someone in a hooded robe. Bobby gets to Joyce and gets shocked by electrical wire when trying to get to her. Billy comes on the TV and tells Bobby that he needs to put hooks through his pectoral muscles and hoist himself up to connect extension cords. Doesn't this game sound a little familiar? Because it was the exact game that Bobby lied about doing. Bobby admits to Joyce that he was never in a trap and Gibson walks up to the hooded man. It's not Hoffman, but instead Dead Boy Dan, who got his arms and jaw ripped off in the car test. Gibson sees monitors in the room and figures out what Hoffman did. He caused the explosion and when everyone left to see what happened, he switched out Dan's body for his own in the body bag. Gibson calls Palmer and a machine gun comes out and blasts him and the other officers. The coroner is getting ready to do his autopsy and opens up the body bag, just to find a very much alive Hoffman. He stabs the coroner in the neck and then stabs another worker. He walks out of the room and stabs a third person. We go back to Bobby and he starts piercing the hooks through his chest. Hoffman attacks Palmer and snaps her neck. Bobby starts hoisting himself up and Hoffman uses Palmer's face to get access into the secured room. Hoffman kills the man who opens the door and takes his gun. Hoffman shoots Rogers through a two-way mirror and Hoffman finally gets to Jill. He opens her cell and Jill shanks him. Jill runs away but can't seem to find any unlocked doors. He hides in a room and we go back to Bobby. He gets high enough to grab the extension cords and as he grabs both of them, his pectoral muscles give out and he falls before he can connect them. Hoffman is searching for Jill and finds her. The timer runs out and Joyce gets put in the Brazen Bull, which is probably the most painful trap in all of the Saw franchise. Joyce burns inside of the machine as Hoffman straps Jill in the chair. Joyce starts to look like Anakin in Revenge of the Sith and Hoffman grabs the OG reverse bear trap. He starts the timer and we finally, after 7 movies, get to see the results of the reverse bear trap. Joe's face gets ripped open 3D style, and of course, Hoffman has to say the famous words.
Game over.
Hoffman runs out of the room and burns his office, including Billy. The building blows up 3D style, and Hoffman gets attacked by three more Mr. Piggies. What the fuck?
What the fuck?
Exactly what I'm saying. One of the men takes his mask off, and it's Dr. Lawrence Gordon. After the first Saw movie, John fixed up Lawrence, and in return, Lawrence did the surgery work for the traps, such as Michael's eye in Saw 2, and stitching up Trevor's eyes in Saw 4. He gave John Lynn's information in Saw 3. We never see their faces, but the other two Mr. Piggies are Brad and Ryan from the opening trap. John asked one thing of Lawrence, and that was to make sure nothing happened to Jill. Now that Hoffman killed Jill, Lawrence is acting on John's final wish. Lawrence chains Hoffman to the same pole that Adam was chained to, and makes sure Hoffman can't get the handsaw with a 3D throw. Lawrence ends the movie by turning the lights off and giving the all-famous line. Saw 7 came out in 2009 and is the last movie following this specific storyline. This movie seemed a little rushed, but that's because they wanted to do a two-parter to this movie, but they only decided to do one part because Saw 6 only made $50 million. What? We'll wrap up the Saw franchise with Jigsaw next week, where we figure out how they keep up this story 8 years later. If you haven't seen Saw 7, go watch it. I try to keep these videos as short as possible, so there's some things I leave out. So there's some things you missed, but you get the gist. My name is Tyler Style, and this has been Beware the Scare. Thank you for watching my Saw 7 video. What was your favorite trap in the entire movie? Let me know in the comments below. I'm so happy that we're almost done with the Saw franchise. Don't get me wrong, I love it, but it's a little much. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll catch you guys later.